Hey friends, you might be wondering what light and sound have to do with English language arts. But it has plenty to do with that, because today we're going to be studying about mass communication. And mass communication is the way that we actually communicate with people near and far. We'll begin by talking about how humans use light and sound to communicate. Mass communication is the term used to explain sharing information on a large scale to a wide range of people in different places. As civilizations developed, think about all the reasons why communication was important, not just for people who lived nearby, but also for people who lived far away. The telephone is a great example of sound technology that's able to connect people who are far away from each other. You're all familiar with the smartphone that we have now, but they are way different than the phone that Alexander Graham Bell invented back in 1876. And that was an invention that changed civilization. By 1918, there were over 10 million homes that had telephone service. And by 1927, the technology had grown so rapidly that people were able to actually make calls from New York to London across the Atlantic Ocean. In the decades that followed, rapid advancement in phone technology was able to improve phones to the point where we were able to have mobile phones. As a matter of fact, the first car phone was invented in 1946, and that phone weighed 80 pounds. For our modern phones, we have two men that we can thank for this technology. First, we have Dr. Henry Sampson. Dr. Sampson actually invented the gamma cell from which all of the cell phones are actually based upon to this day. And then we have Mr. Martin Cooper, who took Dr. Sampson's cell technology and created the cell phone that we are so familiar with. Humans have a need to know what's happening beyond their own communities, and a telephone is a great tool to help us connect and communicate to people both near and far. Mass communication is how we get the news we need to make decisions about our lives and our safety, how we learn and share discoveries, how we conduct trade and do business. It's also how we bond and connect with each other, because human beings are social creatures and we need that bond and that communication with one another. Imagine if you didn't have some type of device, a cell phone, a tablet, a computer to be able to reach out and connect with your friends. How would you feel? How would you react and respond in that type of situation? But what about before we had telephones? How did people communicate then? Throughout history, humans have communicated with each other in a variety of ways. They talked to each other in person, but that meant traveling to where the other person was. And that took time, and plus travel could be dangerous. However, as writing systems developed, they were able to write messages to each other, but that still took time and travel was still dangerous. It wasn't until the 1840s that an inventor utilized a coded alphabet that used a system of dots and dashes that sent messages along electrical currents from one person to another. But who came up with this alphabet? It was actually an inventor by the name of Samuel Morse. He came up with the alphabet and he called it Morse Code. Well, Morse code can utilize light and sound, because if you utilize sound, it's a system of dots and dashes, and the dots can be like this quick sounds. And then the dashes are longer intermittent sounds like. And similarly with lights, you can flash a light on and off, and that's like a dot, or you can flash a light, leave it on for a half a second, and then turn it off, on for a half a second, turn it off, and those will be considered dashes. Eventually, those signals were sent through an invention, again by Samuel Morse, called the telegraph. The person receiving the message at the other end could write down those dashes and dots and decode it on the receiving end. Mr. Morse, sent the first Morse code message in 1844. And that message went from Washington, D.C. to Baltimore, Maryland. Remember how we talked about how important mass communication was? Well, that message sent in 1844 by Mr. Morse was so important for mass communication because it was the first time in human history that a message could be sent and received almost instantaneously, and that actually changed the world. So we've been spending all this time talking about how humans communicate using light and sound, but animals utilize light and sound for communication as well. An example that you're probably really familiar with is the firefly, or where I come from, we call them lightning bugs. A firefly is a winged beetle that has an organ on its abdomen that produces light. Fireflies communicate using the language of light. They flash a blinking pattern, and that's how they find a mate or signal each other in some way. And you're going to be doing some cool activities to help you understand how that helps them survive. Great inventions come from creativity and courage. The best inventions, however, come from trying to solve a problem or help other people. And you won't know if your invention is successful until you make it. So friends, you're going to learn about language in a whole new way. And I know you're going to love it.
To download the free lesson plans to be used with this program, visit us online at wqed.org/SOS. To request a hard copy of the lesson plans, please contact your local school district. Funding for this program is provided by the Pennsylvania Department of Education for Learning at Home.